Alright, Silencer. Silencer as a hero, he can be played in the mid lane, can be played in the carry lane, and he can be played in the off lane. Now, the biggest issue that I'm going to have here is that I don't really know where you rank. So I'm going to actually, because based on the number of games you've played, I'm going to rank you somewhere between 0k and 1k. I'm going to talk about this game based on the assumption that you're somewhere between 0k and 1k. Right?
Okay.
So Silencer is extremely, extremely strong in your games because there is constant fighting in your bracket, right? There's going to be constant fighting, and every single time that an enemy dies within 900 AoE, let me just reconfirm, it's 900 and not 1200. So it's 925. All right. So 925 AoE. 925 AoE, once we get into the game, well, I'll give you rough idea of how much 925 is. So what you need to be doing as a silencer is that you want to be constantly making sure that you are in range of all of these, but obviously you don't want to die before one of these, you know, before somebody else dies. You know, you want to try to be the last one alive. This is a reason why support silencer is pretty decent, because you're gonna stay in the back lines a little bit, you're gonna just, you know, be throwing out spells, not going to put yourself forward, not going to be right-clicking too much. And then slowly, over the course of, you know, 30 minutes, you're going to have, like, 40 int stolen or something like that, and you're going to be hitting, like, a truck, and suddenly you're going to be, you know, a semi-carry. So silencer support is pretty decent. But I think the best way to play silencer is really mid-silencer. Carry silencer is pretty decent as well, but it's kind of a gimmicky thing, because if an enemy hero gets BKB, then you don't really have damage for that 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5 seconds. So it's not that reliable.
But the ultimate for a silencer, it goes through BKB.
Yeah, but that's something that you can do equally as a support or a core. So as a core, the only thing different is your right clicks and your item progression. And your item progression as a support isn't really going to change your ultimate. It's everything is just going to affect your right click. You don't almost never want to buy a AGS on silencer, because it's just going to be a complete waste of gold. If you do want to go that ultimate route to improve your ultimate, then you should get a refresher, because having a 18 second cooldown ult on silencer, or if they have BKB, you ult a BKB to remove your silencer, and you ult again, boom, they are just screwed completely. So AGS is just not, like, all the AGS does is add a little bit of damage. If you look at your, god damn it, this, do you hear noise in the back?
A little bit, but it's okay.
It's the rain, unfortunately. So it's 38 damage. And the damage lasts for 4 seconds, so 38 times 4 is, but damn it, 38 times 4 is 152. So it's 150 for real? It's definitely not that much. 38 times... duration increase, damage 38, don't care about the base... base duration is 6,
right.
It's 38 times 6. It's 228, yeah, that sounds more accurate. So it's 228, and then the additional, every time they cast a spell, it's 152 damage on top of that. But the thing is that if you've got ult, we're talking about your damage from AGS. So if you've actually got AGS, they can't really cast spells because they're silent. So having a curse of silence on top of them, it's literally... it's the damage is insignificant. It's mostly for the slow. But then again, you're making a 4,200 gold item just to slow enemies down for like a few seconds, and that's not even too much slow. It's like just meh kind of slow, you know? What is it, 28%? 18%, it's not 28%, it's 18%. So 18% slow, it's decent. It's an AoE slow, but for 4,200 gold item, it's just not good enough. So AGS is really bad on it. What else? Yeah. So you just want to go damage items, right click items, defensive item as a core, and as a support, you just want to go support items. Actually, I doesn't matter what you're playing Silencer as, core staff is a core, a must guaranteed item on Silencer. So there should be no game of Silencer that you play in which you don't make core staff. It's like you are making core staff.
Yeah, I've learned that's a really important thing to have for him.
And on top of that, the last thing that I wanted to talk about of Silencer is that you want to be in every single team fight. At the end of this game, the KD kill score was 42 to 21. So you guys had 42 kills. So you want to make sure that you're in all 42, essentially. That would be just ideal for you. But as close to this as possible. Looks like you were in 18 plus 11 is 29, so 30-ish. So 30 kills out of 42 is pretty damn good. Pretty good. You want to keep TP on you all the time. Even if you have to just TP into a lane just so that you can be in range, you're not going to contribute anything at all. And every other hero, it'll be like a waste of 50 gold, but on Silencer, it's not. It's plus 2, minus 2 int. And that's pretty big as it starts to pile up. So you want to take that chance. The other thing is, like, which lane are you going in right now? And which lane do you play most leagues?
Well, with Silencer, I feel like he's pretty dynamic, so I can play him in any lane. I prefer mid, but if somebody else already goes mid, then I just honestly go wherever is left.
Okay, so it's really important on Silencer that you know which lane you're going to, because your item build is going to be is going to heavily depend on which lane you're going to. You never ever want to buy a TP or as a first item on any hero in any game at all. So this should have been a Tangos. You always want to start on every single hero in the game. Doesn't matter where you're going. You always want to have at least one set of Tangos. It doesn't matter where you're going, right? One Tangos is a must, 100%. And TP is 100% no. So Tangos is one thing, and normally, depending on the lane, you want to have either one or two sets of regen. And when we talk about sets of regen, we're talking about Tangos and Self. So the difference between them, I hope you know what the difference is between Tango and Self.
Yeah.
Okay. Burst healing and immediate healing and overtime healing. Mm-hmm. Okay, so this kind of build, and the other thing is Boots of Speed is an item that you want to get on Silencer only if you are going in the offlane as a solo, and you never want to play Silencer in the offlane as solo. It's really bad, but obviously in your bracket, sometimes you might get, you know, you might not have any other lane to go to. You might have picked Silencer first pick, and then everybody else picks things, which makes it so that you're pretty much stuck with going to the offlane. So it's fine. Then you want to get boots. Otherwise, you want to have int items here. It's very, very important. Your base mana pool is okay. It's pretty decent, actually, but the thing is, your abilities actually cost quite a fair bit of mana. So you, in the mid lane, you want to start off with a Null Talisman and a set of Tangos. If you're a carry, you want to do pretty much the same thing, Null Talisman and a Tangos. But if you're playing support, then you are a bit stuck with buying the support items, which is going to be a courier and a ward, preferably two wards if you can have the courage for it. But otherwise, one ward should suffice. And then with the rest of your items, you want to buy at least one regen, which is 99% of the time going to be a Tangos. And then you want to have one or two clarities, depending on how much gold you've left over from buying a minimize this windlace. So let's look at the total. Oh shit! Let's look at the total gold. So a windlace is 225 plus a courier is 800 plus a single observer is 62, and then what else did I say? 125 for tangos. So you've got 113 gold left over, so you can buy. Well, to be honest, you can buy another observer. if you don't want to buy it, it's fine. You can buy two clarities and you're set.
Okay.
But you need to have consumables. It's very, very important. You need to have tangos and clarities as a support. It's really, really important. The reason why you're not going to go for clarities as a mid or a carry is because as a mid laner, you are going to be rushing the bottle first. So that's going to be plenty of HP region as well as the mana region for you. And as a support, as a carry, you're not going to really need to spam too many of your abilities. And you're just going to get your regular items, your treads, your core staff. This item, raindrops, really, really good on silencer. You can get it after 3 minutes. As a any role, you want to almost always get a raindrops unless the enemy team has some sort of a hero who can immediately, like not immediately, but really inexpensively take your raindrops off heroes like Storm Spirit. Every time he right clicks you after when he has static remnant or when he has overload charge, show you it. You know what I'm talking about, this guy?
Yeah.
Okay, so he can take it off really easily. Lich can take it off really easily. He's free mana almost. Crystal Maiden can take it off really easily. Sand King. So any hero who doesn't really have to spend too much mana to break your raindrops is a great is a hero that you don't want to get raindrops against. A Tiny is a hero that you definitely want to get raindrops against because for him it's really, really high mana cost to use his spells, and his spells do tons of damage. So pretty much having an infused raindrops will save you your life, and he's not really going to try to break your infused raindrops because he's not going to try and spend all that mana because that could be kill potential. And if he is trying to waste his mana on breaking your raindrops, then that's fantastic because you probably save somebody on the map from getting killed, from dying to Tiny.
Can I get the raindrops in the side shop or?
No, it's just in the base. Okay, as a carry silencer, now let's look at your items as a carry silencer. Right now, you and your skill build, right? So right now you've got boots. What do boots do?
Well, it's they make you move faster, but it's also closer to getting power treads, which are pretty useful.
Yeah, but what I mean is, like, you spent your first 625 gold on buying boots. So what is boots actually doing for you right now for the next, I don't know, 4 minutes? Because essentially you could have had boots at 4 minutes. Let's just say a random number. It could be 3, could be 5, could be 2. I don't know, but let's just say 4. Up to 4 minutes, what are boots exactly doing?
Well, I guess you'd be useless. So.
Pretty much useless because you're
but,
not
yeah,
running
my
away.
My logic was that I'd be closer to getting power treads.
I absolutely understand that, and that's very common when you are starting off playing because you want to rush that first big item. But the thing is, that makes sense. But the thing is that what are you doing up till then? What are they useful for up till the point where you actually have treads? And even when you have treads, what are you really doing with treads, you know? Because you're playing carry right now, you're in this lane, you're not going to be running away from anybody, so that's not the factor you bought boots for, and you're not really going to be chasing anyone. So again, this is not really useful, like up until the first like minute or two at the very least, you're not really chasing anybody. And also this guy has boots as well, so for you to be honest, this guy getting boots is also a bad thing, but I'm going to talk about that a little bit later. So yeah, you're not going to be chasing. What you're doing as a carry is farming. That's the main thing that you're doing. And you have nothing in here, nothing at all. Not going to talk about the fairy fire. You have nothing in here at all that actually gives you damage. And that means when you're trying to right-click creeps down, when you're last hitting, it's going to be harder for you to last it, right? With 50 damage, it's going to be quite hard for you to last it. And we can look after this creep wave. So right now you've had, here we go. You've had 8 creeps come into this lane so far. And out of those 8 creeps, you've got 2. See, so you've got 25% farming efficiency. And a big part of that is because of this low damage, because you've got really, really low damage. Right. second thing is that I wanted to talk about. So yeah, okay. So if you had a null talisman right here, that would have given you 9 extra damage. That means that this would have been at the very minimum 4. At the very minimum. Right, and also when you harass Tiny, it's more damage. You have more mana to use more spells, etc., etc., etc.
Right.
Next thing is that you don't actually have enough mana HP regen, which means that if you want to trade a little bit with the offlaner, if there is a kill opportunity, if let's say you had a stunning hero, something like that, or if Tiny makes a mistake and you go in for the kill and you actually kill him, that's fantastic. You got a kill, you got first blood, all that wonderful stuff. But then you've probably got somewhere around this much HP, or maybe this much HP. You're definitely going to be taking damage because the priests are going to be hitting you. Most likely, this guy's going to turn around and hit you or throw down his stun or something. And then you're going to end up with exactly these items, but this much HP. He is going to come back alive. He's going to TP the lane. He's going to have full HP, full mana. And suddenly, what you're going to find yourself is in a position is that you are actually standing way, way far back. And Tiny is the one just right clicking away, last hitting away, taking all the farm, and you can't do anything because you fear for your life. Because if you come close, Tiny stuns you, right clicks you twice, and you're dead. So that is one of the reasons, one of the 20 reasons that you need to have HP regen items. The other thing, talking about your skill build now, so last word and arcane curse. Let me just go back real quick. When did you actually use your? I didn't notice. Or actually, okay. So you used your ability here at the river. Okay. So you almost never, 99% of the cases, you never want to level up your abilities until you get to your lane, or until you get to a point where you actually need to use that ability, right? So as a silencer, you have three options. This one, as far as level one is concerned, is it slows people down. It slows them. This one nukes them for a very well nukes them for 150 damage and silences them for 4 seconds after a delay. Oh, wait, no, it doesn't silence them for 4 seconds, silences them for 3 seconds after a 4 second delay. And this one actually increases your right click damage. Now, when you are in a rune fight, right here, when you're in a rune fight, 99% of the times at a rune fight, if a rune fight does actually break out, you want to immediately level up Arcane Curse, and you want to throw it down on as many people as possible. It's going to slow them. It's going to deter them from using spells, and most importantly, it's going to slow them so they have to think twice before coming into getting that rune. And you can have the potential to chase them down and kill them and all that wonderful stuff. But you actually didn't even level this. You leveled a last word, which is literally just 150 damage and some silence and. Really, just throwing that down on Tiny was a complete waste of your mana because it doesn't really do that much damage. And also, if you really wanted to chase Tiny or kill Tiny or prevent him from getting the rune, you should have leveled Arcane Curse and thrown that down. He would have been slowed, and maybe you guys could have chased him down and done a lot more damage to him because this guy could have leveled up Tombstone. Obviously, he made the same mistake, but he could have leveled up Tombstone, throws down Tombstone. Tiny goes down to at the very minimum half HP, if not a lot more. And the biggest thing to look at was that the Tiny has absolutely no, holy shit, the Tiny has absolutely no HP regen, just like you. So if you harass him, he's gonna be completely zoned out of the lane, and he's just gonna be less than a creep. He's gonna get nothing out of this lane. He's gonna be useless, right? So at any point, you should have looked at Tiny's inventory and seen what items he has, and you would have you what you want to look for is the mana regen and HP regen, and maybe even stick in case you are a hero who throws down a lot of spells. And stick is a surprise factor. You might want to try and go on somebody trying to kill him. You start killing him, you bring him down to 50 HP. Suddenly he clicks a button and suddenly he's like 300 HP, and now you're screwed because you've gone in too deep into the tower trying to kill him, and now he's just going to turn around and kill you. So, but that's something later on. Right now, you want to check at the beginning of the lane, you want to check the inventory to make sure how much regen they have, how much regen you have, so that you can understand how much can you trade with that person. Now, that being said, Silencer is one of few heroes who has an orb ability. An orb ability is an ability that adds some effect to your right click. In Silencer's case, it's Glaives of Wisdom. It just adds extra damage onto your right clicks. With Drow Ranger, it adds slow. With Huskar, it adds the fire burning thing. So the biggest thing with orbs is that if you actually stand in the middle of a creep wave or anywhere at all, and you click the orb and then you click the enemy, you're gonna throw the right click. It's gonna have the extra damage or whatever ability it was, whatever orb it is, it's gonna apply your damage to them. It's gonna be exactly like right clicking them with one difference, and that big one difference is that none of the creeps are actually gonna aggro to you. Aggro means that creeps attack you, creeps are drawn to you. You know when you right click somebody, creeps come and attack you, or power attacks you? That's not gonna happen. That's not gonna happen at all with these orb people. So if this guy or this guy wants to trade with you, all you need to do is stand in the middle of a creep wave, make sure you're in the middle of a creep wave, and just orb him. And just keep, don't right click this to auto cast it, because that's not that's gonna be just like right clicking him, so you are gonna get aggro. You wanna click it, or obviously, I don't mean click it with your arrow, your mouse, click with your. Yeah, you want to click it and you want to hit the hero, and you're going to be damaging him with your right click damage plus your int damage, and all four or five or whatever how many ever creeps there are going to be hitting him. Whereas as from his side, it's just going to be his damage coming in. So you're almost doing twice as much damage or maybe more to him than he is to you, and that's called an effective trade, right click trade. But you didn't level up your glaives at all, and in this lane, you should have. Whether you're playing carry or support, one second, excuse me.
Bless you.
Thank you. Whether you're playing carry or support, you want to always level up Glaives of Wisdom at level 1, because it's going to allow you to right click, harass, and zone out the offlaner for free. Whereas any other support is actually going to have to go around the trees and make sure they don't get into the tower aggro range. Tower aggro, sorry, not tower aggro, creep aggro range. Creep aggro range is 500 units. 500 units is something like this, about this much. That means that if you are within 500 range of a creep and you right click an enemy, the creeps within this 500 range are going to be drawn to you, and they will start to attack you. So that's something that you don't want to do. And 925 range is okay. 925 range is roughly about, I would say, about this much. About this much. Yeah. So that's how far. How close you need to be to an enemy hero. Oh, wait a minute. I think there is a gold range for. Hold on, let me get that code. Actually, that'll be really, really beneficial. How to draw okay, that's. Dota underscore range display. Okay. All right. Dota underscore range underscore display at 925. Oh, hopefully this works, and it doesn't work. Perfect. Excellent. That's what I like. Nice. Any other way that we can make her? Well, what range is this?
This is 425.
Sorry? No,
He
no, no.
says.
This is not 425. Let's have a quick look. I think cast range is 1,000. Okay, so Arcane Cursed. Oh, there we go. Okay, so Arcane Curse is 1,000 cast range. Perfect. Perfect, perfect. All right, so Arcane Curse right here is 1,000 cast range. So your 925 is just about, oh well, a little bit more, maybe about this much. But this gives you a very good indication of, roughly where you, so you just need to make sure you're closer than this. And you can get this, you can get this circle whenever you hover over your Arcane Curse, right? So that's really useful. What else? Yeah. Okay. So now you had the Spiritbreaker came in, did a bit of an engagement with you, and damaged you. And now you find yourself in exactly the situation that I told you. You have nothing to actually give you mana regen. You have nothing to actually give you HP regen. At this point, really, at this point. If the Tiny was any good, and if the Spirit Breaker had some mana regen, he could have charged you. And if the Tiny was any good, he's level 2 right now. He would have had 1 point in avalanche and 1 point in toss. That means 100 damage from this, 75 damage. And if he has, well, let's just say 75, 175 damage here, and then it's about 65 physical damage though. Because, well, he does have so. Alright, because it also adds the movement speed damage, so god damn it, I'm not going to be able to calculate this right now. Let's just say it's roughly around 80 damage. Hold on, we can actually check. We can check because we can see Spirit Breaker, Silencer, Target, Fresh, Turbo. Second, here we go. Silencer hits you. Spirit Breaker casts Charge of Darkness, and he did 55 damage for the right click, for the Charge of Darkness, and then he clicked you, right click you twice, so he did 55, 56 damage. So it's gonna do 65 physical damage after reduction. That's 55. Point being that it's 175 damage from Tiny and about 100 damage, two right clicks from this guy, and you're pretty much dead. So literally all they need to do is Spirit Breaker needs to charge you and you're dead, and you have nothing to really save you except for a Fairy Fire, which if you do get in time, all that means is that Tiny just needs to make sure that he hits you once during all that stun time, which he guaranteed will. Actually, we might even see you die here if Spirit Breaker actually gets some mana, which he should have by now. Definitely should have by now. Almost. Okay. He's. I think he's preparing. I think he knows that he can kill you. Oh wow! All right, now they know. They still might. Right. So, if you notice, this guy threw the cart at this guy and wasted his ability and mana. Now he has mana for only Avalanche, and they just literally threw away a kill opportunity. So if these guys were even a little bit better than they are, this was definitely a kill on you. Because literally right here, if he had tossed, you would have died. Well, maybe one more right click. Lady thought about doing anything at all. It's just poorly played, and you're actually gonna get killed. Right. So, it's things like these. Instead of them getting a kill on you, which they just threw away, you actually turn around and got two kills on them.
I guess it doesn't happen in higher level,
No, this is not something that will happen. But we're talking about quite much higher level, I think. 2.5k plus. Anyway, your situation has gotten worse now. Even though you guys did manage to get two, why did you not get an assist for it? And, oh, because Tiny actually got too far away. So you actually didn't even get the assist or
No,
the
yeah, or the
insteal.
intelligence.
Yeah, so as far as you're concerned, you literally just got one. Kill one assist out of it, which is something like, I don't know, let's see how much gold it is. Okay, spell that is not shown. I don't want to go back. It's going to be about 100 gold. Roughly about 100 gold that you would get from that assist. If not less. Probably actually less, to be very honest with you. So after this entire creep wave, just let it end. Alright, so 6 minutes means 6 fours are 24, 24 twice is 48. To be honest, this counts as 48, so it's 44. So right now, so far in your lane, there have been 44 creeps. You've had 7 of them. As a carry, that is something that you cannot allow to happen, right? In the 0 to 1K bracket, normally at 10 minutes in, people are gonna have roughly about 10 to 15 CS. So in your bracket, you're doing okay. So let's look at other people's CS. We're not gonna look at the jungler if they have one. Now they have this guy as a jungler. Junglers are always gonna have more CS because that's guaranteed CS that they will get. It's mostly these two guys who are both, I believe they're both mid, or is that guy carry? No, it's actually Juggernaut in the offlane. So Juggernaut is actually doing pretty decently. This guy is mid lane, he's doing pretty decently. So you're actually not doing so well for your bracket either. You, as a carry, need to be minimum top 4. And I say top 4 because, well, I'm not going to include the jungler here, okay? So jungler doesn't exist. So these two are going to be the mid laners, most likely. Sorry, we're talking about last days. So you need to be top 2 as a carry, because the top 2 are going to be the carries, both the carries in the lanes, and the next 2 are going to be the mid laners, and then it doesn't really matter. Well, it's going to be the off laners, essentially. But the junglers, obviously, we don't count them, we don't look at them. Net worth-wise, you are doing not too bad, you're in the middle. Once again, as a carry, you want to be at the top 4 for net worth, guaranteed. Don't even care about the jungler, you need to be top 4 as a carry. Because the jungler, whereas the jungler will get better CS, but the net worth won't be the same because the jungle creeps aren't as valuable. You're going to get like 7, 8 gold from someone. So anyway, so point being, you need to get your last hitting up. That's one of the most important things for you. In fact, that's the number one thing that you need to fix. The first thing that you can do is definitely get better starting items, which will help you last it better. Second thing is, what do you call it? Put higher priority on last hitting. Don't bother going for kills. Don't bother going for harass. Don't harass over a last hit. Meaning, if there's a creep about to die, don't go and harass the person and lose that creep. You can harass them after you take that last hit. If creeps are about to die, don't bother harassing. Just go and take those creeps, just get the last hit, get the CS, and then go and harass. The other thing that you can do, you can go to this arcade game, which is called Last Hit Challenge. Right here is the SF picture one. You can go and practice whatever hero you want to practice. You pick the silencer, you pick 230 minutes, and every single day that you start your gaming, you want to warm up by playing in the Last Hit Challenge, and you want to make sure that you get like 5 to 10 minutes of practice, 5 to 10 minutes of Last Hit practice. You need to get this Last Hit score up. You got that one assist, and that one assist got you 100 gold, which is roughly equates to about 2 CS, right? But the problem is, because you didn't have any HP or mana regen items, you had to TP all the way back to base and then walk all the way back because, and in that process, you lost out at least 2 creep waves. That's 8 CS at the very minimum, 8 CS, not even counting the creeps that were there already when you decided to leave. So you roughly missed out on about 10 CS. Out of 44, you weren't even present for 8 to 10 of them. So that is something that you definitely need to change. So all of this so far is mostly equating to your starting items. Because you went for that brown boots, you have low CS, you weren't in XP range, you weren't in, you know, the last hitting range and all that, so it's really, really affecting you a lot. Okay. So it's really the 10-minute mark that we want to look for. This, yes, okay, that's another mistake coming in. You TP'd into the top lane without even looking at what's happening there. Now, some people, you might say, well, the team was screaming at me for telling me to come there and, you know, fight or whatever. Mute them. If somebody screams at you, telling you to come, just mute them because you need to know what your hero needs to do. You need to know when you can fight and when you can't fight. Muting them helps because if you aren't really sure what you're supposed to do, then having somebody else telling you is actually worse because they definitely don't know what you are supposed to do, right? You know, you're always going to know better than they are. But like, it's better that you don't mute them because you, if they say help, help, what you ideally want to do is click into that lane, see what's happening, assess yourself, and then TP there if you think that you can do something or if you think you're gonna, you know, it's useful. But if they just start screaming, help me, help me, and you just TP there, big, big mistake. And like right here, you barely even saw anything. Like you looked on the mini map, but I couldn't even make out what's happening. All I saw was with this TA at nearly half, nearly more than half HP. That's all I saw. I actually initially I thought it was nearly full HP, to be honest. But for the brief second that you looked at the lane, so you TP'd in there, even seeing that your team is like on the mini map, you can see that the team is still behind the tower and the TA is escaping or running away. You TP in there, so you're gonna miss out on even more gold and XP in this lane because you just TP'd this lane. So it's really the 10-minute mark that we look at for the CS. In 10 minutes, you will have had 82 creeps, including the catapults, in your lane. And that's where your, how do we say, not target, but rather, what's the word I'm. Criteria, benchmark, yeah, benchmark. So that's your benchmark. Like at 10 minutes in, how close are you to 100% efficiency? How close are you to 82 CS? And you want to keep improving that one up until you get to 82 CS and maybe even more, because there is a possibility it's actually possible to get more than 82 CS, which is more than 100% CS, which is crazy, but. If you go onto my YouTube profile, I've actually got a video where I get 132 CS. So it's just increasing your farming efficiency by doing. Once again, you chase this guy. You didn't have four staff. You didn't even check to see if he has equal or less or more amount of movement speed. Turned out he had more movement speed than you do, so chasing him was a complete waste of time. You missed out about 4 CS right here to get that kill, not to mention all the mana that you wasted. And now this team fight is going to happen, and you have absolutely not. If you had mana right now, you could have used ult, and you could have prevented. Well, I say that, and then this guy gave you free. All right, it worked out. So normally, decent LC there. It's not going to help you somebody unless they know guaranteed that they're going to get the kill. He even had Blink Dagger. Did he even have? He even had the test attack. He used test attack. I'm surprised he used test attack. Not to mention that everybody can see he's right there. He used test attack. He still didn't kill you. That is actually quite bad. Yeah, people with better. Right, so normally what should have happened is you don't have mana right now. Is it? Am I audible right now, or is background noise way too
Yeah,
much?
it's a little like, don't know. No, it's fine. Like, no
I'm sorry about the rain.
problem.
Oh, it's the junk ulti turn. So it ended up working out for you, but it's things like these. When these things happen, these are like, I call these a positive reinforcement for mistakes. These things happen, and then you think, oh, whatever I did, it was good because it landed us a good result, a positive result. And then that reinforces your belief in the mistake, and you just keep on doing that mistake over and over again. Definitely chasing that tiny was a bad decision, and definitely not having mana regen was a bad decision. Definitely using spells on that tiny when you can't even kill him was a bad decision. Even though overall it actually ended up being moving on. Okay, 10 minutes has passed and I didn't actually move it. CS, keep paying attention. Alright, so these are the four creeps, the last four creeps, 10 minutes. You don't get any of them. Okay, you don't get any of them. Okay, so you got 14 CS. So out of a possible 82, you've got 14 CS. So I don't know, that's not even 25%, that's thing. My. Another 22 is 17%. So you've got a 17% farming efficiency. So that tells me you are between 0K and about 300K. Sorry, 0 MMR and 300 MMR, which at 150 games played is completely fine to be in. It's really pretty straightforward things that you need to improve on to fix this. Not too bad at all. 17%, that's your number right now. You want to get it up to 20% first, then 25%, and then 30%, and you want to slowly build it up to as high as you can go. Usually, at as I said, 0 to 1K, people are farming between 10 to 15, 10 to 15 creeps per 10 minutes, and then at 1 to 2K, roughly at 1 to 2K. It's gonna be around 30 CS, and then 2K to 3K is gonna go up to like 50, 45, 50 CS, and then 3K plus 3K to 4K is just over 55, 60-ish, and then obviously 4K plus, then they can get close to 70. But that gives you good understanding of how important CS is. Literally, CS is so li CS is very, very closely correlated with your MMR. You improve your CS, you improve your MMR. And the biggest reason for that is the more last hits you get, the more gold you get. The more gold you get, the more items and XP you get. The more items and XP you get, the stronger you are in that game, meaning you get more kills, you basically win the game. So, yeah.
Okay.
Honestly, this game is pretty decent. You've got a support hero. You've actually got, surprisingly enough, you've actually got wards on the map. You've got a courier. The courier was upgraded at a decent time. I mean, this is like a wet dream of every 0K, 1K player. This kind of good matches, you don't even get at like 2K. So you're really lucky. You've got some decent game. This was a decent game. Right, so you still don't have four staff. As a rule of thumb, you don't want to engage too heavily over in team fights until you have your first item as a carry or a mid there as a core. As I said earlier, though, Silencer is a slightly different hero, and this is probably why, as a Slarp, you were having such a hard time, because you're probably playing exactly the same way with Slarp. But if you do this with a Slarp, we've just got treads and partials of another item, you are going to constantly die and not going to contribute too much. And as a Silencer, you kind of want to be in these team fights or close to or around these team fights because you want to rack up those int charges. But definitely on the rest of the heroes who, like, everyone except for Pudge and Silencer, you don't want to be in team fights. So this is not a habit that you should be in. You should get out of this habit. In fact, most high level players, even if they play silencer, they will not TP into fights or not will all try to avoid fights if they don't have their first big item, which they will always have at about, 10 minutes in. You actually had it at a decent time as well. Not a decent time, had it at an okay time, but it was just resting in base because I don't know, you bought or the courier was being stolen from you. Okay, so once again, throughout the game, the one thing common that we've seen is that you don't like to get any HP or mana regen items. That is a very, very that's a bad habit, and you need to get out of it. You need to always have HP and mana regen items. If it's consumable, if it's not like passive HP regen item, for example, this four staff gives you three four HP regen. Four HP regen is not enough. Four HP regen is just okay. So if you have something which gives you actually decent HP sustain, then you don't need to get consumables. But if you don't have those items, then you need to buy consumables. For example, right now you needed to have clarities, or some an item, at the minimum a Sobi mask, which will give you some sort of mana regen, as in Sobi mask plus clarities, because right now you're really suffering as far as the mana regen is concerned. Also, at this point, you want to just right click the Glaives of Wisdom because you're not doing any damage with Glaives of Wisdom. This potentially could have been a kill, not really, but you would have done a lot more damage to him if this wouldn't have been a kill anyway. But yeah, you do tons of damage if you had leveled up Glaives of Wisdom. Actually, it could have been a kill if you'd played it in a few different ways. Okay, so how could this have been a kill? First off, you don't want to level up, so this ability gives you slow, right? And you're playing carry. You're not playing nuker. You're playing carry. So, as a carry silencer, you do the most amount of damage from your Glaives of Wisdom. That's the thing that will scale, and that's the main source of damage. These two are quite static. However, you do get the what's it called, movement speed slow from this, which allows you to chase people down better, allows you to run away from people better, and also, of course, that does quite a similar thing. So right now, if you had maxed out Glaives of Wisdom, and 3 point, you need to have 1 point in this, of course, because it's a silence for a 3 second, very long silence. It's very, very good against many of these heroes. So if you had 4 points in this, 2 points in this, and 1 point in this, you could have slowed here. Well, the slow would have been the same as it is right now, but you would have been doing a lot more damage to her. And your four staff, you should have walked over here and then used four staff, and you would have ended up even farther from him, closer to him. And maybe you could have killed him. Even then, it's actually a maybe. It's hard to have 80% of your int, 80% of, what's it, 70-ish, 686 damage on top of your 200, 256 damage, 256 damage per right click. And this guy has 1,000, so about 5 hits. So let's see if you could have actually gotten 5 hits on this guy. 1, 2, 3, 4. You could guarantee you had gotten 4 hits, but I don't know about that. Okay. Moving on. And then you died. And you died here because, once again, you don't actually have any HP regen. Well, you would have died anyway. No way you could south of. Actually, it's funny. If you had actually had a null talisman right now, you would have survived this most likely, because the null talisman actually gives you 60 HP, and it might have been just enough to help you survive this gank. Oh yeah. So these small items are actually the biggest. The reason why these small items are there in the game is because what they offer for value of money is actually huge. If you look at a null talisman and you compare the stats that you get from a null talisman with other abilities, other items, and you do the math, then it's almost twice as good as the gold value it has. And like with other items, these stats you will get for twice as much. Right, so now you've got a very decent mana region item, but you still don't have any HP region item, and you don't have a TP. That's something that, as we said earlier, that as a silencer, you want to always have a TP, because you want to be constantly part of team fights. Your positioning is okay. At this point, the game is just over. It's a huge storm for now. Or rather, working towards a huge storm, so yeah, I can end it here. Any questions? Sorry about the rain, by the way.
No worries. No, I mean, I never really thought about the importance of the starting items.
Yeah, definitely.
That clearly makes a huge difference, too, and last hitting, too.
Absolutely.
Like, I knew that's been a problem of mine, but yeah, I've slowly been trying to work on it. But I'll try this last hit challenge that you mentioned. I think that could be incredibly useful.
Yep, okay. All right, man.